In this lecture, we are going to study about the basic concepts of thermodynamics. So let's start. Thermodynamics is a science that deals with heat and work and those properties of substance that has a relation to heat and work. The word thermodynamics consists of two words, thermo and dynamics. You all know what is the word thermo related with. The word thermo is related with heat. And dynamics, as the word indicates, is the physical power and the forces producing motion. So it means that this word thermodynamics is related with heat and the changes in this heat to other energy. So we can say that this thermodynamics, it deals with the bulk macroscopic properties of a system rather than those of microscopic constituents. So this thermodynamics is the study of thermal energy in different forms, and it is based on two basic laws. First is that you can't get more energy out of a framework than you put into it in all structures. This is the basic law of conservation of energy. And the second law, which says that the transfer of energy by heat flow has a direction generally from higher temperature to a lower temperature region, or in other words, we can say that processes in nature are not reversible. So let us see some of the basic definitions of the thermodynamics, and before that we'll see what is the scope of thermodynamics. Now this thermodynamics is used to give some important laws, like the laws of physical chemistry and the phase rule, distribution laws. This can be derived from the laws of thermodynamics. It tells whether a particular physical or chemical change can occur or not under a given set of conditions of temperature, pressure and concentration. So it means that it gives us the possibility of a particular physical or chemical process. Then it also helps in predicting how far a physical or chemical change can proceed until the equilibrium conditions are established. So it means that it gives us about knowledge about the longevity of a physical or chemical process. So that is the scope of the thermodynamics. Then we will see what are the limitations of thermodynamics, the study of thermodynamics. The first one we can say is that this thermodynamics is applicable to macroscopic systems consisting of matter in bulk and not in microscopic systems of individual atoms or molecules. So it means that it ignores the internal structure of atoms and molecules. So that is the first limitation. The second one is that the thermodynamics does not bother about the time factor. What does it mean? It means that it does not tell anything regarding the rate of physical change or chemical change. So it is concerned only with the initial and the final states of the system. Now we move on to the basic definitions in thermodynamics. So what are the terms which will describe the whole of the system, or the terms which will be used as the basic building blocks in thermodynamics? So first term which we are going to see is the system. As you can see in this figure here, this system, and then we have here surroundings, and that is the boundary. So what is a system? A system is any specified portion of matter which is under study. Like suppose you are taking a glass of water and you want to see what are the effects of pressure, temperature and heat on that water, then that glass of water will be considered as the system. So that is the system. Let us see system can also be say defined as the quantity of matter or a region which is bounded by some closed surface in space chosen for study. Then the second term which we'll see is the surroundings. Anything outside this system will be called as the surroundings. So we can say that the mass or the region outside the system is called as the surrounding, and anything outside the system which can exchange energy with the system, it has a direct bearing on the behavior of the system, that will be called as the surroundings. And then we have the third term, that is the boundary. So as you can see here, this is the boundary of the system, the real or imaginary surface, it is which will separate the system from its surrounding is called as the boundary. Now we'll go on to see what are the examples of this system. And as we have seen that there are system, surroundings and then boundary, then this will constitute total universe. So a universe is nothing but the system and surrounding which is put together, then that results in universe. And you can see the different types which we have shown in this figure here. Let us see the examples of thermodynamic system. We can take any gas which is in a container, or vapors, or steam, or mixture of gasoline vapors and air, ammonia vapors, and its liquid. So anything which will be taken for study will be a system. Then we can also consider other examples like stretched wires, thermocouples, magnetic materials, electrical condensers, and all these type of things can also be considered as the systems. Now this system, they are of two types basically. One is the homogeneous system and the other is the heterogeneous system. So what is the homogeneous system? A homogeneous system, as the word indicates, will be a system in which there is completely uniformity. So when the system it is completely uniform throughout, it is called as the homogeneous system. Like if you take gases, then these gases are all of same type, they will be uniform everywhere, then we will call this system as the homogeneous system. As you can see in this structure that it is equally, the uniformity is there in the design here. So this type of system will be called as the homogeneous system. If you take the mixture, in case of liquid, if you take the mixture of water and alcohol, then that will be a homogeneous solution. Then the second one is the heterogeneous system. So when the system consists of two or more phases which are separated from one another by definite boundary surfaces, it is called as the heterogeneous system. As you can see the example here, if you take the mixture of water and oil, then you'll have a surface separation between these two, this will be called as a heterogeneous system. If you take in case of solids, the mixture of iron and carbon, that is steel, it gives you a heterogeneous mixture. And if you take the combination of copper and zinc, then this will be homogeneous. And in this way we can have different types of homogeneous and heterogeneous systems. Now on the basis of type of exchange of energy and the nature of boundary, they are again divided into different types. Here we have isolated system, then closed system and the open system. Now first we'll see what is meant by isolated system. As you can see in the figure here, the isolated system is shown here. This is the isolated system and this is the closed system and this is the open system. So isolated system is said to be isolated when it is when it can neither exchange energy nor matter with the surroundings. So this system will not exchange anything, neither mass nor energy, with the surrounding, then this is the isolated system. If you take for example a thermos flask which is filled with hot water or hot tea, then that can be considered as an isolated system. A closed system is a system which can exchange energy but not matter with its surroundings. So this type of systems will be called as a closed system. So it is exchanging it can exchange a heat energy, but there will be no exchange of matter. So mass is not exchanged with the surroundings. Then the third is the open system. Now this is the system where we can exchange both heat as well as matter with the surroundings. So this is called as the open system. So for example, tea in an open cup will be taken as an open system. Then we can see again in this form also, this is an open system, it is exchanging both heat as well as matter. This is a closed system, it is exchanging only heat. And this is an isolated system which is not exchanging anything with the surroundings. So you can take a pressure cooker as an example of a closed system. Then you can take a rubber balloon filled with air and tightly closed. Then that can also be taken as a closed system. Then the gas combined confined between a piston and a cylinder will also be taken as a closed system. Now what are the thermodynamic variables? The thermodynamic state of a system is determined by four observable properties. Now which are those four observable properties? These are the composition, the pressure, the volume and temperature. So these four properties are called as the variables of the state. So we have the pressure, volume, temperature and composition. But if you take a homogeneous system consisting of a single substance, then the composition is fixed. So it means that to determine the state of a system completely, then we only need three variables, that is the pressure, volume and temperature. So these variables are known as the thermodynamic variables. So we have these as the thermodynamic variables, that is pressure, volume and temperature. Now for a system in general, there is an equation of state, that is f of PVT is equal to 0. So this equation is called as the equation of state. The pressure, volume and temperature are not independent variables. Thus the thermodynamic state of a homogeneous system is determined completely by knowing two out of these three variables. So we have these three variables P, V and T. Out of these three variables, if you know any two variables, then we can determine the thermodynamic state of the system. For example, if you take the equation of a state for an ideal gas in a static condition, it is represented as PV is equal to RT, where R is the universal gas constant. So these are the thermodynamic variables.